The House will come to order. The invocation today will be given by Father Tim McCabe from Pope Francis Center, Detroit, Michigan. Will members, staff, and guests in the gallery please rise? Father.
Good morning. We take a moment as we begin this first legislative session of the year 2024 to pause and give thanks and praise to you, Almighty God, for you are the God of life and the source of all of our strength and all that is good. We ask you, Divine Spirit, to send your blessing and guidance on these, your servants gathered in this place. These, your beloved sons and daughters, have answered your call to serve the people of this great state of Michigan and to protect and defend this fragile experiment in America we call democracy. Rarely, if ever, has courageous leadership been so required of this body of your public servants. Yes, God of life, courageous leadership in these dark times, to refuse to allow bomb threats and death threats and threats of all kind to deter us from the important work of governing. And so we call upon you, Great Spirit, to spread your armor of protection and care around every single one of them. We beseech you to keep them safe from all evil and harm. There is an even greater courage you call them to at this moment in history, the courage to restore civility, to heal our wounds, and to mend our brokenness. We know that you, God of love, call us to care for the poor and the least among us. We know that you hold precious all of our citizens and that you ask us to care for and value the dignity and worth of all people, regardless of whether they look like us or pray like us or love like us. We know that you will judge our success not by the economic gains of the wealthiest of our state, but on how we lift up and care for the least among us. Send down your Spirit to guide us so that we may courageously put aside divisive and demonizing language and recognize our differences as our strengths, and that those across the aisle from us, we recognize, love and care as much about this state as we do. Do not allow our differences to prevent us from working together in solidarity and unity. Help us, Lord, to make all of our decisions and choices on the side of love, not hate, on the part of inclusion rather exclusion, and upon acceptance rather than rejection. You call this legislative body to be the beacon of light, not only to our state, but to our nation, to be the example of disagreement with civility, of differences with respect. Make us beacons of what true servant leadership looks like. This Almighty God, we know, is our highest calling and your desire for all of us. Help us, Lord, to hold on to and not grow weary when times get tough, knowing that your mighty hand guides us and protects us as we seek to love justice and show mercy. We offer these prayers in the name of Jesus, in the name of all of your holy people. Amen.
The clerk will open the board for the purpose of taking attendance. The board is now open. Members may check in at their desk. Channel 62, CBS Detroit, TV 19, WZMQ Marquette, 9 and 10 News, 9 and 10 from Cadillac are all allowed to record.
Speaker recognizes Majority Floor Leader Ayash.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move to excuse all absent members.
Without objection, so ordered. The clerk will close the board, tally, display, and announce today's attendance.
Madam Speaker, a quorum of the House is present. There are no members absent with prior excuse.
Will members, staff, and guests in the gallery please rise and join me now in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Majority Floor Leader Ayash.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move the clerk be directed to notify the Governor and the President of the Senate that a quorum of the House has convened pursuant to the requirements of the Constitution and is ready to proceed with the business of the session.
Without objection, so ordered. Speaker recognizes Majority Floor Leader Ayash.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move to see the order of message from the Senate to read in the message notifying the House that they are ready to proceed with the business of the session.
Without objection, so ordered. The clerk will read.
To the Honorable Speaker Joe Tate from Secretary of the Senate Daniel Oberlin. Dear Mr. Speaker, by direction of the Senate, I hereby notify you that a quorum of the Senate is assembled and is ready to proceed with the business of the session.
Message from the Senate is referred to the clerk. Speaker recognizes Majority Floor Leader Ayash.
Madam Speaker, move the House proceed to order motions and resolutions.
Without objection, so ordered. Speaker recognizes Majority Floor Leader Ayash.
I move to send a respectful message to the Senate requesting the return of Senate Bill 227.
Without objection, so ordered. The request is granted. Speaker recognizes Majority Floor Leader Ayash.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move the House proceed to the order of message from the Senate to take up Senate Concurrent Resolution Number 12.
Without objection, so ordered. The clerk will read. The House will stand at ease at the call of the chair.
The House will come to order. We have a memorial resolution. Members, please take your seats. The clerk will read. Clerk will read.
To the Speaker of the House of Representatives, dear sir, I herewith transmit to the House of Representatives Senate Concurrent Resolution Number 12. A concurrent resolution of tribute offered as memorial for Doug Kruse, former member of the Michigan Senate and Michigan House of Representatives.
All members in favor of the memorial resolution, please rise. The resolution is adopted. Members, we have the family of the Kruse family that are here. Please rise and be recognized. I think they departed. Thank you. The House will go at ease.
Speaker recognizes Majority Floor Leader Ayash.
Speaker, just let the members know there will be no further voting. The House adjourns to Senator until Tuesday, January 16th at 1:30 p.m.
Without objection, so order. The House will stand at ease at the call of the chair.